Which is better for hair fall, platelet-rich plasma or mesotherapy?
Thank you for your question. You're asking a question which is very simple, and hopefully I'll be able to educate you as to what our approach is to hair loss is. You're asking what is better for hair fall, PRP or mesotherapy? So what essentially you're asking is what non-surgical and non-pharmaceutical option is better from these two injection options. Well, I can certainly give you some guidance. I'm a board-certified cosmetic surgeon practicing for over 20 years in Manhattan, Long Island, performing hair transplant surgery as well as non-surgical solutions for hair loss. In fact, I'm the founder of Trichostem Hair Regeneration Centers, which is based on hair regeneration treatment we've developed in our practice using a combination of platelet-rich plasma and extracellular matrix. So in fact, our approach has been so successful that it has dramatically reduced the number of hair transplants we perform in a given year. Patients come from all over the world for this treatment. So I'm going to give you a little bit of perspective based on my understanding of the two options you asked for before we discuss how we approach hair loss in our office. So to begin with, what does PRP do? What does mesotherapy do? Well, certainly I can help you with the PRP. PRP is platelet-rich plasma. It's derived from your own blood, and it is a concentration of the wound healing factors that stimulate certain key elements to the skin when it's injected. So it'll improve fat cells, it'll improve blood supply, it'll improve the collagen. And secondarily, it will stimulate short-term growth of hair. Now, from our experience and from the experience of patients who come to us who have had PRP injections done elsewhere, the challenge is that you need frequent treatments. You have to go at least once a month, and in some places, once every 2 to 3 months. But it means that you're getting only short-term benefit, and you're not getting long-term sustainability. Now, the subject of mesotherapy, for those of us trained in the United States and trained in allopathic medicine, and even with this understanding of some of the elements of what constitute mesotherapy. Mesotherapy is something of a controversial issue because in other areas, particularly in European countries where mesotherapy is practiced, there is some belief in its value. Mesotherapy is essentially the use of various vitamin solutions and other things that are injected into areas, whether it's the face or the scalp. I personally do not perform mesotherapy, but from what I understand, I would not consider mesotherapy to be of any value for hair loss. And I don't wish to disparage anyone or insult anybody, but frankly, hair loss that is 95% is genetic hair loss. It is not from vitamin deficiency or any other nutritional or conceptually the delivery of even a DHT blocker into the skin, because it doesn't work that way. Hair loss is genetic. And the ways that we treat hair loss in the United States are basically, prior to what we've developed, is pharmaceuticals, which include minoxidil and finasteride. In our practice, many people come to us who don't want to take finasteride because of fears of sexual dysfunction. While on the other side of that is hair restoration surgery, which a lot of people won't do for a variety of reasons and because of the limitations. So you can only have so much hair that you can transplant before you run out of donor area. That's the true limitation, regardless of technique. So hair regeneration is what we do in our practice. What we developed is based on a technology of wound healing material called extracellular matrix. When combined with platelet-rich plasma, it was discovered in our development that during hair transplant surgery, thinning hairs actually became thicker. We were able to help the graft survive better, We were also able to help the donor area heal better. But what's different from PRP alone is that we're able to do a single injection treatment and see significant improvement over the course of a year to 18 months. We follow our patients every 3 months and we document extensively using digital microscopy as well as digital photography to document the improvement. We sometimes also do a second injection at the 12 to 18 month point to further enhance and build upon. It's not like the treatment regresses, but we're actually able to improve upon that. With more than 5 years of data, we've been able to at least clinically verify that the treatment is sustainable and that the hair growth continues without constant injection. I think that's a big differentiator from either PRP or mesotherapy. Usually there's some type of continuous within a year, several injections necessary to sustain the results. Again, these other treatments, these PRP and mesotherapy, won't stop progression. With hair regeneration, we've been able to show over and over for patients who we treat from around the world that we're able to stop progression, reverse thinning, and thicken existing thinning hair. So I realize you've asked a different question, but I think it was important for you to at least get some perspective since you are obviously looking for a non-surgical alternative to hair transplant, that there is also this other treatment that's an injection called hair regeneration. So learn more about this option, and I with no intention to confuse you, but rather to educate you, I want you to learn and do more research so that you feel comfortable about your knowledge and the understanding of what the long-term plan is. You know, it's very important. When people have hair loss, they're often very desperate and they will try anything. And I mean anything. So it's better to at least take a step back from the desperation and think about the long-term plan and think in terms of years and decades and not short-term solutions, even though that may be what all you find when you just learn about just PRP and mesotherapy. So now you have a third alternative that I think will make a bigger difference for you. So I hope that was helpful. I wish you the best of luck, and thank you for your question.